all my brothers was hustling, so dope. I used to ride around with my cousin, a white boy, while he hit licks. All through Cynicwood, all through Homestead, you know. I basically grew up in the streets, man, you know, because everybody around me was hustling.
That's what I love about Slim Thug. He is consistent the whole way through.
One, he got the talent. Two, he got the hustle, man.
Slim Thug is one of those people I always respected, man, as a person and as an artist.
Consistency, bro. The nigga consistently put out good shit. He consistently kept it real, bro.
We used to stand on the corner banging that UGK. If you see some things, don't hesitate to send them my way. I got a pocket full of stone.
Represent where the fuck I'm from one time, man. You know what I'm saying? Nigga over here been, you know what I'm saying, doing this shit for about 15 years, man.
I first heard about Slim Thug through a friend of mine in New York who's a lawyer, and the first time throwing his records, like, you just knew that he not only rep for Houston, he rep for the South.
I got my deal with Interscope through LaToya Luckett. I was dating her at the time at one of her studio sessions, and her manager at the time, Terry, heard me rap on one of her songs, which then led to him passing my demo. Well, he made me put together a demo that he would hand to Jaha, who was over at Geffen Interscope. And Jaha actually is the one who signed me. He was my A&R who had me over there at Geffen Interscope. And that's how I got over there.
Slim was, like I said, very business-minded. I mean, he asked for things that most artists don't ask for in their life. I want to make such and such per record.
They also had to sign one of my artists and give me a label situation also. And I was still able to do my independent stuff too, which was a plus.
Killer Collyon, Boss Hogg Outlaws, you know what I'm saying? Boys in blue, we run the streets and we make the rules in it.
I entered the booth, it's killer the truth. All the rest of these niggas just useless. So if you step to the mic thinking your ass is in it, your motherfucking bitch ass is useless. I'm out of Houston.
I put all that on the table and I figured, all right, if I promote my other independent cats and just bring them everywhere with me, you know what I'm saying, promote them. And when they see me, they see them. They eventually get accustomed to them and start knowing them. And I can drop an independent record with them, and then they'll still have that worldwide.
Look, the diamonds pressing up against the wood grain wheels. Wheel tipping, sitting sideways off in my DeVille. Coming down lane, switching butter seats. Brain gripping, candy frame on a set of swings with the brains.
By allowing him to continue to put out his mixtapes, it's going to make him that much more attractive as a major selling artist, because he's still got his dirty underground. He's still got his base that he's still giving records to. He's still showing love to. No one's ever going to be like, oh, he just got signed. Now he's just thinking about, you know, the pop kids and MTV and you know, just doing all the flossy stuff. Now he's like, I'm still, you know, going to service the mom and pop retail, because I'm a mom and pop retail.
The formula at Interscope is put the new artist with the hot producer. And, you know, me and Pharrell got together when he came out in Houston. I played him a couple records, he played me a couple records, and off top, you know, I was like, man, that's Pharrell, Skateboard P, man, you know, I'm a rap.
Yo, that shit in there, though?
You
hear
me?
That shit.
Check
I'm gonna do this shit, but I wanna have her.
Where's the engineer?
Fuck that nigga, Slim! Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, yeah. And then right when the, who the boss, nigga? Who the mark? You ain't Slim, you the motherfucking boss, fuck them niggas! But we get in the back, like, popping shit to the top of our lungs.
You know the name Slim Thug out the now. What? AKA Slim Thug of the bow. Cow shots like a bow. They glass like a bow. Time drop like a bow. On time like a bow.
That's the motherfucker. Who the boss, nigga? Get down. that out there, and then come back with my life, then come back with this shit. That, now that's in your face. Who the boss, nigga? Who the boss, nigga? Who the boss? Nigga, you got me ready to jump on that motherfucker. Who the boss? That's call out, nigga. Who the boss? Play that motherfucker again. Now you talking. Hey, that's the motherfucking call out. Who the boss, nigga? Tell me. Come on.
How many niggas do you know go to Cancun to lace they crew? I do it for you.
Yes, sir. Yeah, see, this is what's happening right now. Yeah. Motherfucking trouble.
Change your whole attitude. It's time to take off your cool. If it makes you want to move, then move. My niggas get up on it. My bitches know what's at. I'm back, I keep on it. I know you heard it.
Young Texas, A-Rod, KG of the game, LeBron James. You niggas must don't know my name. I'm Slim Thug, a motherfucker, the big boss of the South. And I'm just talking with my mouth, I back it up with my mouth. Before Jimmy cut the check, it was 50 on my neck and over 50 in my ear. I'm the rookie of the year, I'm here for the takeover, not to replace over. It's a new hustling time, get a break.
I wasn't sure how Slim Thug's sound was gonna mesh with the Pharrell sound, though.
The lyrics were slipped up, but the music wasn't what we were doing here.
Pharrell, like, one of them type of next-level producers.
And, you know, his music is, it's kind of more on a commercial type thing, and I just didn't think that it fit him.
I got my deal before Mike Jones, Pow Wow, and Chameleon there, and then me and Pharrell were already linked up before them, you know what I'm saying? Before Still Tipping reached its peak and took over the United States, when I got signed, the Houston sound wasn't going nowhere past Houston, you know, for the most part, you know what I'm saying? But as I got a deal, Still Tipping became the started to take off, and the Houston sound was more accepted. And at the same time, I was probably like, I don't know, 6 months into the album, and already platinum was, you know, on some whole nother level with for real stuff, you know what I'm saying? So it was kind of, I was kind of late with the Houston sound taking it major, you know what I'm saying? Still Tipping took it major, the Houston sound major, but at the same time, I was doing an album with Pharrell, which was, you know, on the Star Trek that wasn't really, you know, all Houston sound, you know what I'm saying? But at the same time, I love that music, and I still picked that album, you know what I'm saying? Probably, you know, one day it's my favorite, next day it's my second favorite, you know what I'm saying? But I still love the music, but at the same time, I feel like I should have dropped my Boss of All Bosses album when Still Tipping pop and took it to the Pharrell level after.
And for us, coming from Houston, we still was feeling like, man, these labels everywhere, these people from really that's really, really out of town, they don't know about our culture, they don't know about our music, they don't respect us and none of that, you know what I'm saying? So when we saw that, it showed it, man. For one, Pharrell respected Slim and our culture. He appreciated it, you know what I'm saying? He believed in Slim and his music. And he also, you know what I'm saying, showed Slim, you know what I'm saying, all different types of artists, you know, all the people that Pharrell was working with, you know what I'm saying? Next thing you know, Slim working with him. So that's a hell of a middleman right there, you know what I'm saying? You hear Gwen Stefani and Slim Thug, man, that's a hell of a song. Beyonce and Slim Thug, that's some real stuff right there, man.
You know, when I got it, man, I just was being myself on that. You need to stop playing around with all the clowns and the gangsters. Good girls gotta get down with the gangsters. You know what I'm saying? And that's another one of those things you envision. Hey, man, Beyonce is the top girl in the city, you know. If I ever got a chance to do a song with her, I'm gonna do it like this, you know. And I got my chance, I took advantage of it. Song went number one, won MTV awards. You know, it was just a blessing, man. It was a blessing to be able to do good music and for it to go number one with the hometown hero, man.
Beyonce featuring Slim Thug, check on it.
Watch it. can't get
wow.
a
oh, we have two. Oh, thank you. I wasn't expecting this. I actually don't know what to say. Of course, I have to start off with thanking God and MTV and Slim for being a part of the record.
Shout out to my boy Bun B, who ain't here the whole H-time. Much love, and thank you to Beyonce and whoever called me to get on this record, man. Much love. H-time.
I remember, man, we went to the Tyra Banks show, and that was a beautiful thing. I was so excited, because at the time, Tyra was that, she was that girl, and I've been, like, since, you know, High Learning plotting on Tyra, man, so I'm excited. I've been there, man, and I'm happy we doing the interview, but of course, to get on Tyra as a new artist, they got to bring for real. That's the, you know what I'm saying, the way it had to make it happen, make it make sense. So we get on there, and you could tell off top, she was on them. You know what I'm saying? She was on my boy, Skateboy P.
What makes Slim Thug so special for the third time?
All right. Slim is an entrepreneur, and he's like all about his business. He was, dude was a millionaire when I met him.
Slim Thug, you were a millionaire first.
Yeah.
I already platinum.
Wow. Yeah. Okay.
So it was like, you know, he had been hustling his tapes and mixed CDs.
Oh, that's what you meant by already platinum.
Yeah.
Like you had already sold platinum on your own.
Yeah.
I was doing independent stuff. I wasn't actually signed to a major label, but I just...
That's what I'm talking about.
Right.
Okay.
Right? So, and what makes our arrangement so incredible is that he still owns his stuff. You know what I mean? He's not one of those guys that depends on what everybody else depends on. Like, it's his business.
Mm-hmm.
So.
And Slim, can I call you Slim or Mr. Thug?
Whatever you want to call.
Okay. Whatever I want to call. All right. So, Mr. Thug.
Yeah.
How has your life changed since hooking up with Pharrell?
Well, I definitely got a lot more female fans. Yeah. It's been crazy though, you know. I went from, you know, being in Texas and people recognize me a lot out there in that area to coming to LA, New York, and everywhere. You know, people notice
Miami.
Me.
Now,
so
Miami.
That's what it is.
Yes, sir.
Shout out to Miami, all that.
We out here, man, you know what I'm saying? I done brought MTV down back to the city again, man. My boy, man, Sway.
Did that I jump is. In this right here?
That
I'm still
is,
tipping
man.
On foes too, baby. Come on.
H-Town, man, we doing it big. We got the slabs out here. We finna do this vibe shoot. You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna do it big for the city, baby. Slim Thugger, fuck a hater.
Power Wild, the people's champ, representing for the Swisher House on that 5-9 South Lee. You know how it go down. We still tipping and we sitting sideways, baby. Y'all already know.
It's going down, baby. April 19th, next Tuesday, my album store.
Who is Mike Jones, April 19th? We back doing them with the Volume 2, Ice Age Volume 2, the takeover.
Who? Mike Jones. Who?
Hey, I see Slim, the whole boss all got on playing domino with Mac and them.
Slim Thug, my partner, you know, first and foremost, above all, he my partner.
It's the people's champ.
I'm talking about
something like a baller.
We got Vibe Magazine over here. We in the hood, baby. It ain't over. We gonna keep doing it, man. Bringing them boys down here to this H. It's just like an inspiration. Just let us know that this shit can really happen for us. And that's why we here today, you know, with the steel tipping and all that shit. It's all because of the boss.
No. Suck in, Pop.
Yeah, this is what you call a slab. See how you tip these foes at ease, baby? Slab right. This is what you call a rider slab. Fuck the right of way. This is the rider slab.
At that time, when still tipping was popping, man, the momentum was pretty much with Mike. You know what I'm saying? Mike Jones, he just started taking out when still tipping popped, and then he backed out with a couple more records that was killing it. You know what I'm saying?
Before I came up in the game, nobody showed me love. They see me in the club and used to treat me like a scrub.
He came out and he actually sold more records than everybody in the city, I think. You know what I'm saying? Like 2 million, like over 2 million records. You know what I'm saying? So at that time, Mike Jones was on fire. And you know, shit, we was just out eating out for still tipping, and as it made the movement go. With Mike Jones, they had us performing on BET Awards. I think we even performed at the MTV Awards. We did Still Tipping. The Still Tipping was like the driving force of the Houston movement at that time, you know what I'm saying?
Sideways, boys in the days.
part where I was right on time with it, because first of all, he a white rapper who, you know what I'm saying, probably realer than a lot of niggas I know, you know what I'm saying? So to have him do that, represent with the grill, man, he was just so, you know, unique and doing what he was doing. And then he still had that swag, and it wasn't nothing. He ain't trying to act black or nothing. This part wild, you know what I'm saying? He real, you know? So when he came through and then he killed him with the sitting sideways, he's so Texas with his style. So, you know what I'm saying? It all made a lot of sense, man. And we've been doing it since like 9-9 together, you know? Underground, and to take it to this major level, man, it was a blessing.
They see me rolling, they hating, patrolling and trying to catch me riding dirty, 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 trying to catch me riding dirty.
Chameleonaire was one of the, you know, biggest artists out of the city without a deal, you know. And the thing about Chameleonaire is he was so ahead of time with the internet. Like, I remember telling Chameleonaire, man, you're a nerd or whatever. You know, you're always on the internet, you're on the computer and talking about that. Because I wasn't even understanding this. And he'll be, you tripping, bro. I'm telling you. And then he began to build a real solid, you know, fan base through the internet. And he was touching the world way before a lot of us was. And getting money, man. And being real successful with it. So, you know, he always been smart. He always had that live-ass style to him. And he had Riding Dirty, man. Riding Dirty was one of the biggest songs. He won a Grammy for it, you know what I'm saying? And sold like 2 million records, too. So at the time, the city was on fire, man. And I was actually recording in L.A., and I was looking for a Phantom at the time, and I found a blue one online. And just so happened it was down in San Diego, man. And I, you know, I had a few homegirls and my homeboys with me. We rolled out there, man, and pulled it straight up off the showroom floor, paid cash.
This the one I want. Ring me up. Pass me the title and let me get the hell out of here.
This nigga ain't got no insurance.
What is that?
Once again, straight off the showroom floor. Cash money, ain't no notes, ain't no. We out of here. With it. It was just a beautiful feeling, you know what I'm saying, to be young like that and really living my dreams and being able to do what I want to do, man. It's just the freedom that money gives you, you know, when you're coming from nothing.
That is, like a boss.
I got mink flows in my shit, fool. I'm from the hood, my nigga. Agony, you know me. I remember I see my nigga Nego shit. We was in Japan, remember that shit? Y'all seen this DVD? I told y'all I was gonna get one of them motherfuckers out.
We way out there putting it down, baby, today, baby. Check them out. Look at that.
It's just an unexplainable feeling, man. That's why it's so important, you know, that I tell people, man, chase your dreams. You know, live life to the fullest, because you only live once, you know what I'm saying? You don't get no second shots at it.
One half of the clips, hell half no fury. October 8th, we not playing no games. Houston, they pull my records off of the fucking station, but I'm coming back with a vengeance. Niggas can't talk like the boy, I'm telling y'all this shit. I'm choking the motherfucking mic, man. Ugh. Star Trek Entertainment.
Shout out to H-Town, Alex
and Boy. What's up, player? Hey.
What's up? We up in Miami. Off of Ocean Drive. A little bit back, y'all seen us way on the other coast in LA. On that side of the water. Now we at this side of the
country. Nigga had some private two hoes in my room. He let him get my 10 mugs out of the counter last night. Bitch was so shot, I wouldn't have had a prison on that over. Ugh!
Shit right here, man. So motherfucking funky. I'm talking about pulling this something mean. Dropping the top on that hoe and just riding, man. I felt so official at this time. You know, like you come up and you see, you know, all these celebrities and everything. on Cribs, and you are, you, at that time, if you're a rapper, you telling yourself, man, when I get on Cribs, I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna do that. And I remember always saying, man, when I get on Cribs, I'm gonna put a candy slab, you know, represent Houston, you know, do it right. And I had two drop legs out there. I had the $75 on Swingers, Papa Trump, outlet. We had the 70 Cooperville, the Big Boss Hogg out there, man. I had the Blue Phantom. I had about 10 cars at the time, 760s, a Bentley Coupe. I had a bunch of cars at that time. It was just like, you know, that's just nigga mentality, man. You know what I'm saying? Shit, you get you some money, a nigga gonna go get a bunch of cars and jewelry, because that's just what we think, you know, symbolizes success, I guess. But at the same time, what was different between me and a lot of other rappers was I had been rapping since 98. So instead of me having to get a deal and just buy this and buy that, buy this, buy that, I had already been building years before. I ain't just go out and buy these 8-carat earrings or, you know, watches and 10 cars at one time. I already had a Bentley and I traded it in for that Phantom, you know what I'm saying? I just kept going up level by level. Started with the fucking 2-carats and now I'm at 8, you know, I just did it like that.
The reason why we play this nigga Stumps, this nigga shit jamming. You can't deny the boss. You know, you got some niggas won't kick it down, they man play my shit. You can't deny hits. You can't deny hits. Hit after hit after hit. Boss got the flow, boss got the voice, and I need an album cover. I need an album cover shout out. Rob G on my shit. I need that freestyle gonna pick me for the relay.
I'm here, man. You see me. Go to endthemix.com or whatever. I'm in the club. You know what I'm saying? A lot. I'm in the motherfucking streets. You roll with me today. I ride.
We ride through the motherfucking ward, Fifth Ward, you know what I'm saying? Northside, H-Town. I represent all this. Fifth Ward, 44, Homestead.
This the street I'm from right here, Gore. We gonna go back up that motherfucker. I'm finna holler at this nigga here. H! What's up with it, baby?
What's up, baby?
Chilling like a motherfucker, man.
Riding through the hood in this big old thing,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, trying to, man, I'm riding.
Doing it,
you
know,
my brother, baby.
Keeping it hood.
That's what nigga ain't trying to do.
That
boy
Slim rubbers in that homestead.
What's up,
man?
I'm
about to be all right. We out here in the scenic woods, man. Where the fuck we from? A word? How am I a cuz?
What's going on? Oh, that's fly, G. Appreciate that, man. That was love, homie.
Good meeting you, dog. Boy, they drew a picture of me. Look out.
Nigga see Slim Thug. That's why I get that love, because they see me, you know what I'm saying? The rest of these niggas is ghosts.
Gio, let me show this shit up. One of my fans flagged me down in the street.
He drew that picture, you know what I'm saying? So appreciate that, G. You know what I'm saying? I got it right here on my dish. I know you thought I'd probably throw it away or some whole shit. I'm not that type of nigga. At that time, when that took off, the Houston scene took off or whatever, man, it was crazy, man. I had to do a lot of stuff. I was so uncomfortable at first. And then, you know, eventually you got to just get in your head, man. Hey, man, you know, you can't be mad at nobody for loving you, having love for you, you know what I'm saying? So you got to, as a rapper, you got to take that time and do that. You know, if you want to be a rapper, you got to do rapper stuff.
Hey, that's how they do it all Slim Thug first, man. We got all the man. And if he my nigga, I ain't take care of him. What's up, baby? See Wiggum up in this bitch. These boys getting fucked up and shit, baby.
Yo, what up, Slim? It's your girl, Shamika. Happy birthday, baby.
This one busting up, man. It's going down, baby. It's going down. Chillin', man. Good, we in here, baby. What's up, man? This nigga been the truth for a long motherfucking time, man. This nigga the truth, man. Fuck what you heard.
We all the
motherfucking truth, man.
We all the truth, man. We
all the hot songs out of Houston. This nigga have been a part of that shit. Wanna be a baller? He was a part of that shit.
I just do what I do.
AJ motherfucking WK, man. That's what's up. The knob to the south, man. AJ WK, man. Not the hardest, but the smartest artist in the industry. Let him know, man.
Hey, man,
I'm gonna spit the truth. RIP to my nigga, Matt.
Man,
this nigga the
truth, man.
Go down, boss, all that loud. The Four Star Click, baby. I ain't just a DJ. I ain't just a DJ, man. That's all I gotta say.
Oh man, that was just, you know, so dope to work with, you know, Cartoon. He's like one of the greatest tattoo artists, you know, that I know, you know, and he done so many people's stuff, like, you know, famous people. He did Dr. Dre hands, Eminem, he did 50 Cent back. He did so many people's stuff. And I just feel like, man, if you're gonna get a tattoo, something you can't erase, like, that ain't nothing you need to be cheap with, you know what I'm saying? So I definitely wanted to go to the best, and I'm definitely proud of all the work I got, and got tattoos that a lot of people, you know, end up duplicating, you know, and I ain't hating on that. You know, if you like it, you can do it, that's love. You know, they do the Texas, they be redoing that a lot. They do the Houston on the back, man. It's just, he just give me real art that people, you know, love and enjoy, man. So shout out to some Cartoon.
Skin is the craziest canvas, man. It's the only canvas that moves, shows up strong. Fucking art directs you, get you chewed. Has to fucking bounce a check on you, you know, any other canvas, it just sits there, you know what I'm saying? Nah, but as far as artwork, I mean, I'm constantly looking to improve myself. The road to creativity, man, it's always under construction, you know what I'm saying? It's like I'm always practicing and looking at how can I make tattoos go faster and cleaner and bigger looks, you know?
Is there any way you can put outlaws on that shit too? Like in the middle of that shit?
Everyone's different. This canvas is different than his and his.
Yeah.
So it's sometimes you tattoo somebody and they eat fish and exercise and swim and, you know, don't smoke, don't drink, and they have milky color, smooth skin.
Yeah.
And there's a homie from East LA that eats tacos every day and fucking smokes PCP and, you know what I'm saying? Fuck around and this shit like leather, man. You know what I'm saying? you just gotta adapt, man, you know what I'm saying? Just deal with that shit right then and there. There's no mistakes allowed. You gotta be focused. I can't be arguing with my old lady or fucked up about some shit that happened in the past or worrying about the future. Yeah. I have to be right in here, right now, for that person.
Oh, this is, I'm with my boy Benny Boone right here. This is real big shit. Yeah, getting tatted up by Cartoon, fucking my little Benny.
It's all in the family too.
That is.
That's my 6 years up front.
Yeah, that's just clean. I wanted one of them motherfuckers, man. But my license, I was just on probation about my license. Like on some, you know what I'm saying? Couldn't get no more ticket shit. I just got some more tickets.
Yeah.
My sister just called me and told me, they just sent a letter saying my shit's suspended.
Hey, you bitch, you bitch. Okay, okay.
I slumped up about. You know what I'm saying? I don't go get that bullshit on me. I get the real shit. Everything I do to the fullest.
I gotta get this instrumental out for this computer. Do I gotta burn it on CD or you can just take it straight out there?
It's a fire.
iTunes.
Yeah.
It's iTunes. All
right.
I'm already platinum. Shot calling. We keep it cracking. Don't get the tripping, man. I'm already platinum.
Why
are you
saying
that? Man, I'm already platinum.
I don't think they ready for this beat. We gon' take them boys to Texas right quick. You know the boss talk shit, walk shit, blow shit like it don't cost shit. That's why I'm the boss, bitch. Got a million worth of cars, bought $1 million house. For making words rhyme off my $1 million mouth. You can see the rocks gloss when you see the boss walk. I keep my lips closed cause it costs when I talk. I'm so flashy, rim so glassy. Pull a dropper out, we gon' show them boys nasty. Hood rats harass me, I don't want the drama. They wanna get put up so they can be my baby mama. But I'ma chill, I'd rather work with Will and throw them foes and grills on candy automobiles. I'm still
cool. Ladies and gentlemen,
ladies and gentlemen. Ladies
and gentlemen. Oh, man, working with my boy Jazzy Faye, man. He's a character, man. My boy is just so fly and so turned up, man. He a big boy, man, you know what I'm saying? We in the studio, and I'm just, you know, going through his album. And, you know, we about to get in my session, but I'm going through his album or whatever, and he played this song, Incredible Feeling, man. And it was just so swagged up, man. I just told him, man, I got to have this song, man. That's still, to this day, one of my favorite songs I ever did. Me and Jazzy Faye, man, we just, at that time, man, I remember that being like my favorite song on the album for a long time.
With them diamond chains and rings, it ain't hard to peep it. You can catch me in the shop in my ridiculous bags. Check my restroom trash, all I do is pop tags.
Support Jazzy Faye, Show Enough Records. I'm over here at the Slim Thug video shoot. A song called Incredible Feeling, which I produced originally for my album. And he heard the record, and I just felt like, you know, him being from Texas, that tempo, I think it was real perfect for his album. He coming out now. I think it was real timely that he came out with this record, Incredible Feeling.
Cash to the ceiling.
Sensation, incredible feeling. In this past year, I done made a few million. I tried to
Gio, doing good, man. Day almost over with, man. I don't feel like I've been working. I've been chilling. Having a good time.
Uh-oh, check this out, H-Time, outside. The boss motherfucker brought my nigga Young Jeezy out to this motherfucker, man. He's gonna mix it up with the motherfucking boys in blue. This boys in the hood mix with the boys in blue, baby. Let's do it. Whoever ain't rapping, get the fuck back for a minute. No.
We need some boys in the hood doing anything.
Change your whole attitude. It's time to take off your cool. If it make you wanna move, then move. My G's get up on it. Ladies, throw it back. It's like you want it. I know you heard it. Shoot
then.
Slim Thugger. One BTIP, baby. Wow, so go loud. Hey, hey, when I hit the club, all the girls show me love. Line up the bar, got drink bottle. In the VIP with the chick center. This a TIP, Bun B and Slim Thugger.
Nigga, we hustlers, we please our customers. Pay me all, I'm a busher, yeah. This is my life. In the hood, we funnel dope by the bundle. I make a fucking ton, bro. This is my life, niggas. Bentleys to Hummers, winters to summers. You can't take it from
without
us.
What I'm home saying.
Almost over, man. Boy, I made a good album, man. Give my boy credit.
We ride it.
Let's get to it, G. That's how we do it, G. I grind hard if anybody time to.
Man, you already know this is what 410 store. It's packed, man. They showing love, man. My pops called me from Maryland, said he couldn't get the CD from Best Buy Circuit City, dog. It was sold out in Maryland, man. This nigga doing it big, already platinum. You already know I wrecked the bonus disc, man. Boys in Blue Service Leg coming real soon, man. It's already, you know what I'm talking about, man.
Mr. Rogers.com.
That's how we do it, man.
It's been a long, long day, man. You know what I'm saying? A lot of autographs signing, and ain't even over yet, man. We still got a long way to go. We gotta go to Shaq, tear it down. Then we gotta go to Harlem Nights.
So we gonna be popping it all night.
Man, I gotta leave tomorrow and do it all over again in Dallas, man. You know what I'm saying? Don't stop.
Do it, G. Where you been?
All right, dude. I got you.
What's up? Slim Thuggy. This is your homie, Jay Prince. I'm out here kicking it. They tell me this shit documentary. You know, I don't normally let niggas put cameras in front of my face. But when a nigga say he down with Slim Thuggy, he got a pass. So what's up, homie? I wish you success on this album, you know what I'm saying? Because you've been representing Houston.
Okay.
And you represent the North Side.
Yeah,
you know, keep it real. That a nigga go right there.
Slim, is this nigga really with you or what?
Huh?
Is that nigga really with you?
Yeah. That's my nigga
right there. I'm on the right. I told the nigga he got a pass because he with you.
Jay, this the nigga who started this shit right here, man.
Check it out. Y'all know I don't normally let officers sit in the car with me, so it's got to be a real nigga right here. It's Perk right here. You know what I'm saying? It's Perk. So when you see a nigga sitting in the car with a friend, the nigga is silent. You know what I'm saying? So I don't want y'all, you know, talking about no snitch shit. This is a silent nigga right here. I want to get that shit straight on camera, because I heard a nigga about that. So yeah, keep it real. I wish you the best, man, on that album. You know, you handling your business. Represent the Houston, represent the North Side. And nigga, give me one of them ghetto boy shirts that I saw you on in the video, because I cut for that. Yeah, D7 to 7, ghetto boy.
Bundle dope out of bundle, I make a fucking ton, boy. This is my life, niggas. Bentleys to Hummers, winters to summers, you can't take it from us.
Without my whole saying.